Wherever people live, they are always exposed to different types of risks. But just as their lives and livelihoods are being shaped by the physical places they inhabit, so too is their adaptability and resilience developed to address different threatening or dangerous conditions. Where people live also determines what kinds of disasters they need to be aware of. Just like other species, to survive, there's a need for humankind to adapt to their environments. All risk reduction is grounded in understanding the conditions in which people live, and by using the skills and abilities of the people who work with those conditions. Southern Africa has many different human habitats. Rural agricultural areas that may be densely or sparsely populated, but always dependent on climatic conditions, land and water. Rural towns and markets have their own limitations. Pastoral landscapes pose other risks to the health of people and animals. There's the inescapable need for water, but also riches create their own problems for the land, but also for the society. People who live in or near forests have the benefit of abundant water and many other natural resources. But there can also be too much water and other threats too. Mountainous or steep, high-altitude terrain are challenging environments in which to maintain a secure livelihood. Productive resources can be limited and infrastructure easily exposed to damage. The land itself can easily suffer from the elements, but there can equally be human-induced risks created by altered landscapes. Coastal, marine, and island environments provide a wealth of natural resources, but they also come with a high level of potential risk of loss and damage to the people who live there. Nature threatens, but the mark of humankind remains. With the rapid and often uncontrolled growth of African cities, there's reason to be concerned with threats to peri-urban, former outlying areas of cities. Land and other natural resources can be threatened easily without planning. People are endangered without having basic services. Sickness also kills. So, who or what can protect all these human habitats and all of the people who live there?